मस्तिष्क की शक्तियां सूर्य की किरणों के समान हैं, जब वो केंद्रित होती हैं, चमक उठती हैं। भारत के साहित्य जगत का एक ऐसा ही चमकता दमकता सितारा आज हमारे बीच है। नेशंस बेस्ट सेलिंग ऑथर का खिताब 2013 से लगातार फोर्ब्स लिस्ट ऑफ 100 मोस्ट इन्फ्लुएंशियल सेलिब्रिटीज, ब्रांड्स एकेडमी द्वारा इंडियन ऑफ द ईयर अवार्ड, बिजनेस एक्सीलेंस अवार्ड और ऐसे कई नामी ग्रामी पुरस्कारों से सम्मानित है हमारी मेहमान प्रीति शेनॉय। प्रभा खेतान फाउंडेशन और एहसास विमेन की ओर से हम तहदिल से आपका उदयपुर में स्वागत करते हैं। आज उपस्थित सभी को नववर्ष की शुभकामनाएं और मुझे बहुत खुशी है कि 2019 के कलम के पहले सत्र की शुरुआत हम प्रीति जैसे व्यक्तित्व के साथ कर रहे हैं। जब आप जैसी उत्कृष्ट लेखिका कलम में आती है तो हमारे मातृभाषा की जड़ें और भी मजबूत हो जाती हैं। प्रीति अत्यंत प्रतिभाशाली है। ब्लॉग्स, कृतियां और किताबों के अलावा वे यूनाइटेड किंगडम यूनिवर्सिटी से पोर्ट्रेट पेंटिंग की डिग्री भी हासिल कर चुकी हैं। अपनी किताबों में जहां भावनाओं, वृद्धावस्था, प्रेम, बीमारी, बचपन का वर्णन करती हैं, वहीं टिंडर, ऊबर, सोशल मीडिया, रोमांस का भी जिक्र है। क्या है इस अनूठे मिश्रण का राज, हम जानने के लिए उत्सुक हैं। इनकी किताबें हमें कहीं ना कहीं छू ही जाती हैं। प्रीति बैंगलोर से है और एक कलाकार लेखिका के साथ वे एक पत्नी और एक माँ भी हैं। आज हर बुक स्टोर में इनकी सारी ही किताबें चमचमाती हैं। ये महिला सशक्तिकरण का अमूल्य और दृढ़ उदाहरण है। प्रीति, वैसे वाकई आपकी मुस्कान से आपकी उम्र का पता ही नहीं चलता, लेकिन आपका लेखन आपकी बुद्धिमता और अनुशासन का प्रमाण देते हैं। कहानीकार की दिलचस्प कहानी सुनने के लिए मैं इन शब्दों से बातचीत आगे बढ़ाती हूँ। अब मंजिल के साथ रास्ते भी पसंद हैं, अब मंजिल के साथ रास्ते भी पसंद हैं, और क्या कहें, आपके हौसले भी बुलंद हैं। शुक्रिया।
प्रीति शेनॉय जी के बारे में ऑलरेडी आपने बात करनी शुरू कर दी और इंट्रोडक्शन भी दिया है, लेकिन मैं विशाल कपूर, CEO एंड जनरल मैनेजर रेडिसन ब्लू उदयपुर, तहे दिल से आपका स्वागत करता हूँ। आई वेलकम यू प्रीति। सम थिंग्स इवन आई वुड लाइक टू से, कुछ चीज़ें मैं बोलना चाहूँगा। प्रीति शेनॉय जी, शी इज़ अमंग्स द टॉप 5 हाइएस्ट सेलिंग ऑथर्स इन इंडिया, इज ऑल्सो इन द फोर्ब्स लिस्ट, लॉन्ग लिस्ट ऑफ द मोस्ट इन्फ्लुएंशियल सेलिब्रिटीज इन इंडिया। हर वर्क हैज़ बीन ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू मैनी लैंग्वेजेस। इंडिया टुडे हैज़ नेम्ड हर एज बीइंग यूनिक फॉर बीइंग द ओनली वुमन इन द बेस्ट सेलिंग लीग। She has been awarded Indian of the Year Award 2017 by Brand Academy for her contribution to literature. She's also been also received the Academia Award for Business Excellence by the New Delhi Institute of Management. She has given talks in many premier educational institutions, which is IIT, IIMs, corporate organizations like KPMG, Infosys, Accenture. She's also an artist specializing in portraiture and illustrated journalism. Her short stories and poetry have been published in various magazines such as Condé Nast and Verve. She has a very popular blog and also writes a weekly column in the Financial Chronicle. She has a massive online following. Her other interests are travel, photography, yoga, which you just mentioned, The Beauty and the Age. Her books include 100 Little Flames, It's All in the Planets, Why We Love the Way We Do, The Secret Wish List, The One You Cannot Have, in many others. A very warm welcome once again, and big applause for Prithi Shenoy.
Thank you so much.
So, आज का सफर फिर शुरू करते हैं प्रीति। जैसे उदयपुर जो है, आप बैंगलोर से आ रहे हो, मैंने बैंगलोर में काम किया है, तो बैंगलोर से एक ट्रांजिशन जो है उदयपुर का, और उदयपुर को जो है वेनिस ऑफ द ईस्ट बोला जाता है, एंड वी टेक ग्रेट प्राइड। एक ऐसा शहर जिसमें इतने सारे छोटे छोटे लेक्स हैं, और इसकी सुंदरता और इसका जो आकर्षण है वो बिल्कुल अलग है। सो व्हाट इज इट दैट यू वुड लाइक टू टॉक अबाउट द ब्यूटी, और आप आए हैं फर्स्ट हैंड, क्या फीडबैक है आपकी?
पहले जो मैं ये कहना चाहती हूँ, आपने जो हिंदी में बोला मुझे 50% समझ में आया, 50% नहीं समझ में आया, क्योंकि मैं लिखती तो अंग्रेजी में हूँ, एंड माई मदर टंग इज कोंकणी, एंड आई हैव बीन ब्रॉट अप एंड मोस्टली इन द साउथ ऑफ इंडिया वेयर वी डोंट स्पीक हिंदी, यू नो वी स्पीक इंग्लिश। सो sorry, yeah, no, no, I understood. So then, you know, then I said, okay, Kalam, I don't want people to think, oh, she's the snob who speaks only English. You know, so I didn't want people to think that, because I do have great respect for Indian languages. I speak Malayalam, main Kannada bol sakti hoon, Tamil I speak Konkani, my mother tongue, which I'm very fluent.
That's the format of Kalam.
Right. So that's wonderful. So I said, okay, fine, I get a chance to practice my Hindi, you know, because down south we don't speak. पहले तो मुझे उदयपुर बहुत बहुत अच्छा लगा. मैं पहली बार आ रही हूँ उदयपुर. मैं जयपुर बहुत बार गई हूँ, लेकिन उदयपुर आई नेवर गॉट अ चांस. सो द मोमेंट आई गॉट एन इनवाइट, मैंने बोला येस आई विल स्पीक, आई मीन आई विल कम टू उदयपुर. बट आई सेड इज इट ओके पार्टली इफ आई स्पीक इन इंग्लिश, देन दे सेड इट्स फाइन. सो एंड मुझे पहले यही लगा कि यहाँ पे ट्रैफिक बिल्कुल ही नहीं है, क्योंकि मैं बैंगलोर से आती हूँ. मुझे आज मैंने घर से मेरा 12:45 का फ्लाइट था, मैं घर से 8:30 को निकली, क्योंकि 2.5 hours लगता है बैंगलोर एयरपोर्ट पहुँचने में, इतना ट्रैफिक है और एयरपोर्ट दूर भी है. तो इधर जब मैंने लैंड हुआ, मैंने जो पिकअप करने वाले आए थे, मैंने उनसे पूछा कि कितना टाइम लगेगा होटल, तो उन्होंने बोला 45 मिनट. तो मैंने बोला बस उतना ही, यू नो दैट्स ऑल ओनली 45 मिनट्स, बिकॉज दैट्स व्हाट आई कम फ्रॉम. एंड देन ब्यूटीफुल होटल, आई लव द होटल. जो आई मीन कितने लोग यहाँ पे इंस्टाग्राम पे है, अच्छा तो आप मेरे स्टोरीज देख सकते हैं, मैंने वही डाला है कि बहुत बहुत ब्यूटीफुल एंड ऑल उदयपुर स्टोरीज आई हैव पुट एंड ब्यूटीफुल व्यू फ्रॉम माई रूम आउट. बहुत बहुत खुशी हो रही है आप सबके साथ यहाँ पे होने की. सो थैंक यू सो मच कलम फॉर इनवाइटिंग मी एंड थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग इन कॉन्वर्सेशन विद मी.
थैंक यू सो मच प्रीति. माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन विद यू इज दैट द बुक्स विच यू राइट, उसके अंदर कहीं ना कहीं जो आपकी रीडर्स को एक उनका सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड टू गेट दैट इंस्पिरेशन आउट, यू आर ऑलवेज सेंडिंग अ मैसेज एंड डीप डाउन समवेयर यू आर वांटिंग टू बिल्ड द सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस इन पीपल,
राइट?
व्हाई सो?
मुझे यही लगता है कि अगर आप, अगर कोई भी लेखक कुछ लिखता है तो उसमें देर शुड बी समथिंग विच दैट पर्सन कैन टेक अवे. सो एज अ राइटर इट्स आई फील यू नो यू गाइस व्हेन यू रीड माय बुक देर शुड बी सम टेक अवे फॉर यू, यू नो व्हाटएवर बी इट वेदर इट मेक्स यू फील हैप्पी, वेदर इट मेक्स यू क्राई. तो इट वॉज नॉट डेलिबरेट, मैंने ये सोच के नहीं लिखा कि आज मैं ये कहानी लिखूंगी और यू नो 100 जन इंस्पायर हो जाएंगे और वो जाके एक बड़ा काम करेंगे, ऐसे कभी नहीं सोचा था. मैंने सिर्फ वही कहानियाँ लिखी एज दे कम टू मी, यू नो इट्स नॉट अ कॉन्शियस थिंग दैट आई एक्चुअली सिट एंड थिंक एंड आई राइट. दैट्स हाउ इट कम्स टू मी एंड दैट्स हाउ आई राइट एंड आई फील वेरी हैप्पी. मुझे आज बहुत सारे मैसेजेस आते हैं, हर दिन मैं मेरे इंस्टाग्राम पे स्टोरीज पे डालती हूँ, फेसबुक पे पोस्ट करती हूँ, जो लोग लिखते हैं कि आपके बुक्स ने हमको इंस्पायर किया, बिकॉज ऑफ योर बुक आई फील कॉन्फिडेंट, आई फाउंड अ वॉइस. मैंने कभी ये सोचा भी नहीं था कि वॉट एवर स्टोरीज दैट आई एम राइटिंग पीपल विल फाइंड अ वॉइस, बट आई फील वेरी गुड अबाउट इट बिकॉज आई फील व्हेन अ राइटर राइट्स कुछ ना कुछ, यू नो यू शुड फील समथिंग, कुछ महसूस होना चाहिए आपको पढ़ के जो भी मैंने लिखा कुछ, देन आई फील इट्स मीनिंगफुल लिटरेचर. नहीं तो आप कोई भी यू नो यू टेक अ वेरी फैट बुक, वेरी हाई लिटरेरी राइटिंग, बट इफ यू डोंट फील एनीथिंग वेन यू रीड इट, what's the use of that literature? You know, it might be great, it might win a great award or something, but for me that human connect is very important. So that's what I strive to do in my writing and I'm very happy that agar you know log inspire hote hain mere kahaniyan padke to mujhe bahut khushi hoti hai is baat ki.
Preeti, acche sawal puchna mera kaam hai aur main ek aur sawal jo aapko puchne wala hu wo ye hai ki आप एक एविड ब्लॉगर हैं, आप राइटर हैं, आप चित्रकार हैं, इलस्ट्रेटर हैं, तो आपकी जो रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टुवर्ड्स द सोसाइटी, आप एक मैसेज देते हैं और आपकी इतनी बड़ी फैन फॉलोइंग है, इतने सारे लोग हैं जो वेट करते हैं आपके ब्लॉग्स का, तो आपको क्या लगता है व्हाट इज दैट यू फील टुडे आफ्टर कमिंग ऑन अ सर्टेन प्लेटफॉर्म दैट व्हाट इज योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टुवर्ड्स द सोसाइटी, व्हाट डू यू वांट टू गिव बैक? There is, you talked about the connect, the human connect, which is very important. But somewhere there is, I would say, a certain social cause which you have at the back of your mind. And what is that?
टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, मुझे यही लगता है कि नॉवेलिस्ट्स आर जस्ट देयर टू टेल अ स्टोरी. ओके, नाउ इफ यू, आई फील नॉवेल एज अ मीडियम ऑफ चेंज इज द स्लोएस्ट मीडियम. स्लोएस्ट मीडियम अगर आप चेंज लाना सकते हैं तो आज यू नो इंटरनेट का जमाना है, आप change.org पे पिटिशन डाल सकते हैं, यू नो. सो इट इज वेरी यू नो इट्स वेरी व्हाट कैन आई से, इट्स नॉट राइट टू थिंक दैट आई विल राइट अ बुक एंड द वर्ल्ड विल चेंज. आई मीन दैट विल बी वेरी इम्प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ मी टू प्रिज्यूम दैट. सो नॉवल इज द स्लोएस्ट मीडियम ऑफ चेंज. सो आई जस्ट टेल स्टोरीज एंड आई डोंट थिंक एज अ नॉवलिस्ट इट्स माई ड्यूटी to be a social activist. मैं कभी ये नहीं सोचती कि मेरे novel से एक social message है, because if I do that, you know, then the novel stories become very preachy. So, but then what happens is people take that away from my novels. Okay, so it'll be usually a downtrodden woman. If it's a woman, it's a very strong woman character who, and I reflect reality. So these are stories based on real life. So then she will stand up, she'll fight for herself. For example, ये book जो है Rule Breakers, इसमें एक यू नो 19-year-old वेदा की कहानी है, भारत के एक छोटे शहर जोशीमठ में, यू नो दैट्स वेयर इट्स सेट. एंड उसके तीन बहनें हैं, एक भाई है, और उसके पिताजी यही यू नो दैट्स व्हाट ही बिलीव्स दैट गर्ल्स शुड गेट मैरिड, गर्ल्स शुड नॉट हैव अ करियर. बट उसका जो सपना है, शी वॉन्ट्स टू बिकम अ प्रोफेसर इन अ यूनिवर्सिटी. सो वॉट हैपन्स टू हर ड्रीम आफ्टर दैट, एंड इट इज रियालिटी, लाइक अ लॉट ऑफ यू नो सो मच प्रेशर ऑन गर्ल्स इन अ सोसाइटी इवन टूडे टू गेट मैरिड. So I never think that this is a message that I have to convey and I'll write a story about that. But invariably it so happens because I just take from society. Main jo dekhti hoon around me, I take my inspiration from that and I write. And then people feel inspired because, you know, Veda does something with her life. People feel inspired. So I feel as a novelist, I'm primarily not trying to inspire or motivate. But people take that away from my novels because they're able to relate to the character. My characters are very real. So they're able to relate and I feel good about that.
Thank you so much. Very beautifully answered. My next question is that there's a book which you had written in 2011. Mm-hmm. The topic was, you know, the book was named Life is What You Make It.
Right.
It is about a girl, Ankita, who's yes. got this bipolar, you know, disorder.
Yes.
Ek bada gambhir subject tha aur bada serious topic tha. And I would say it's also a very bold move at so many years back.
Right.
Almost 7 years back, aapne ye jo kitab likhi, to iski jo aapko, I would say, the courage or the inspiration which you got, could you just tell us about that?
To us time main UK mein thi, to tabhi main ek exhibition dekhne gayi thi, aur bahut hi sundar paintings the udhar. फिर मुझे ये मालूम हुआ कि वो पेंटिंग्स जो है वो बाइपोलर आर्टिस्ट्स एसोसिएशन के पेंटिंग्स हैं. तो जो भी वो पेंटिंग्स बनाए हैं सब लोग का बाइपोलर डिसऑर्डर है. सो देन आई बिकेम क्यूरियस अबाउट इट. और उस टाइम मेरी मुलाकात एक साइकेट्रिक नर्स से हुई यूके में, तो उनसे बहुत बात की. फिर मैं इंडिया जब मैं आई, मैं निमहांस गई और मैंने वहाँ पर बहुत लोगों से बात किया. Our, that's how the idea grew from there, you know. Then I said I wanted to write a book about it. So, and then what I did is I wanted it to be related, you know, relatable for young people. So I said I'll make it in a college. And that's actually based on my college. Because I said, you know, people should be able to relate to that book. So I made it a young girl and I made it, you know, I set it in Kerala and people could relate to that. So the book starts with a scene in a mental hospital where she's sitting and she's waiting to see the doctor, and then she says, you know, I'm not like that, this is not my world. Then, and she was very bright and all of that. So it's like a thriller. So I've written it like a thriller. But, you know, as you rightly mentioned, this was way back, and I must be the only writer who got rejected, not only in India, but I went to UK and there also I got rejected. More than 40 times that book was rejected. So nobody was willing to publish that book. Okay, so everyone rejected it. कोई तैयारी नहीं था वो publish करने के लिए कि you know एक mental hospital की कहानी है, किसको पढ़ना है, nobody knew. And today that book has sold more than 500,000 copies.
Wow.
Yeah. And it continues to top up. You know, any Nielsen list you take, that book will always be there. So I feel very good because दो साल मैंने research करके वो book लिखा था. और उस टाइम बहुत दुख हुआ था कि यू नो पीपल आर रिजेक्टिंग. I said, oh, nobody will know about my Ankita. My Ankita will be trapped in the computer. Wo computer mein hi rahegi. I felt that, but today I feel good. That time, it was a very difficult book to write because I had to get into the mindset of that mental patient. Okay, so I spoke to so many people and I was very sad when I was writing that book. And then I used to wait for my friend's call from India and I used to wait for my husband to get home because it takes you to a different space, you know. But then I understood a lot of what it feels like to be trapped inside your own body, to be trapped in your own mind, to be helpless. So I understood that. So I feel it has made me grow as a person and I'm quite glad I wrote that book in retrospect.
Preeti, ye sawal nahi hai, lekin jab main aapse thodi der pehle baat kar raha tha, aur jab aap hotel mein aa rahi thi, yahan par bhi kuch jo hamari mahila staff hain, unhone bhi bola, oh Preeti ji aa rahi, maine bhi unki kitab padhi hai, aur unhone particularly is kitab ke bare mein bola, aur jo do teen feedbacks mujhe mili, unhone ye bola ki ye kitab padhne ke baad jo jis soch mein wo pad gayi, us character se bahar nikalna, us kitab ko padh ke usko ekdam se bhool jana aur dusri kitab ko utha lena, उस पे उनको एक थोड़ा सा टाइम गैप चाहिए तो मैं ये सवाल नहीं बट मैं उनकी फीलिंग्स के बारे में आपको बता रहा हूँ शायद वो वेट कर रही हैं आपके ऑटोग्राफ लेने के लिए उसके बाद मेरा जो अगला सवाल है जो माय नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू यू इज दैट एज बीइंग द बेस्ट सेलिंग ऑथर सेलिंग सो मेनी बुक्स हाफ अ मिलियन कॉपीज एंड सो एंड सो फोर्थ समवेयर वेर ऑन दैट प्लेटफॉर्म डज इट ऑल्सो गिव यू अ काइंड ऑफ कॉम्पिटिशन टू योर सेल्फ and you are inspired to come out even with better stories and a you know better characterization and you know visualization is it that
yeah definitely because I feel that I grow with every book because as an artist I'm always striving to write better you know my next book should be better than my previous book because if I don't do that then I stop growing okay it's very important to grow so you know it's I always you know as a funny example I always say Saif Ali Khan वो पहले मूवी में कैसा एक्ट कर रहा था यू नो एंड देन आपका यू नो सी द डिफरेंट लेटर मूवी सी ओमकारा मूवी में उसका एक्टिंग कैसे थी एंड कंपेयर दैट टू फर्स्ट वन सो आई ऑलवेज से दैट यू आई बेटर माई सेल्फ और मेरा पहला बुक जो आया था वो 34 बबल गम्स एंड कैंडीज था उसका टाइटल सब ट्रू इंसिडेंट्स सब सच्ची घटनाएं मेरे लाइफ से And then, you know, last year when I read it, I said, kya bakwas writing hai, I have to rewrite this book, okay? I really felt that. So, and I told my publisher, I said, see, so much has changed, I've grown as a writer. So we relaunched that book. It's called Love a Little Stronger. And that book I'm quite proud of. And I'm aware that 10 years from now, I might say, oh, I'm a better writer. But then I said, okay, at some point you have to leave it alone and move on. बट इट्स वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट टू कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग अगर आप एक कलाकार हो तो वो रियाज बहुत ही यू नो महत्वपूर्ण है अगर आप लाइक इफ यू वॉन्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर सेल्फ यू हैव टू कीप प्रैक्टिसिंग देर इज नो टू वेज अबाउट नॉट राइटिंग नॉट ट्राइंग टू बी बेटर एंड आई नेवर बी सैटिस्फाइड विद व्हाट आई राइट यू नो आई ऑलवेज फील नेक्स्ट बुक इज बेटर सो दैट्स हाउ दैट्स व्हाट इट इज
अभी मैं आपको जो आपके लेखन है जो आप लिखते हैं उससे मैं थोड़ा सा बाहर लेके जा रहा हूँ आप जब एक स्टोरी कैरेक्टर्स विजुअलाइजेशन द थिंकिंग मोड ऑफ अ राइटर एंड सडनली यू ऑन द इलस्ट्रेशन साइड ऑफ इट किताब का कवर उसका पंचलाइन या उसका शीर्षक क्या ये चीजें पैरेलल चलती हैं कि पहले आप बुक के कवर के बारे में सोचते हो डिजाइन के बारे में सोचते हो फिर उसके कैरेक्टर्स के बारे में स्टोरी के बारे में या इज इट अ पैरेलल ट्रैक बोथ ऑफ देम बिकॉज एज दे सी देयर इज अ सर्टेन अमाउंट ऑफ अट्रैक्शन व्हेन यू लुक एट अ बुक इन द कवर एंड दे से दैट यू शुड नॉट जज अ बुक बाय द कवर बट अ कवर और द इलस्ट्रेशन ऑन दैट प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल एंड समवेयर आई सी दैट इवन योर लेटेस्ट बुक द रूल ब्रेकर इज गॉट अ फेंस एंड द स्कार्फ अ स्टोल ऑन टॉप ऑफ दैट सो हाउ डज इट वर्क फॉर यू
तो जब मैं लिखती हूँ मैं कभी ये नहीं सोचती मैं रीडर के बारे में नहीं सोचती मैं कवर के बारे में नहीं सोचती बिकॉज दीज आर ऑल द मार्केटिंग एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ इट सो व्हेन आई एम राइटिंग आई एम टोटली डिवोटेड टू माय क्राफ्ट ओके सो आई डोंट थिंक अबाउट माय रीडर आई डोंट थिंक अबाउट हु इज गोइंग टू रीड इट बिकॉज इफ यू डू दैट इट इंटरफियर्स विद द क्रिएटिव प्रोसेस बिकॉज इफ आई एम गोइंग टू सिट एंड वरी ओ व्हाट विल माय कवर बी लाइक देन माय स्टोरी यू नो हाउ विल आई प्रोग्रेस विद द स्टोरी सो दैट टाइम आई एम लॉस्ट आई डोंट लुक एट इट एट ऑल बट वंस आई फिनिश राइटिंग द बुक Then I work closely with the designers and then, of course, the publishers have a say in the cover and then then that thinking process comes only later. So I wear my marketing hat only when I remove my author hat. So when I remove my author hat, you know, then I say, okay, fine, now another part of my brain comes into play. But when I'm writing, I'm like totally isolated. I will not be answering the phone. My friends all know it. My phone switch off karte hoon. And I don't see the social media, nothing, because I feel, you know, big time wasters, social media. But when I finish writing for the day, then I switch on my phone, then I look at social media, and I say this very openly. Whoever wants to write, they ask me, like, you know, what should we do? I'll say, first you switch off your phone. You know, shut down your internet, remove your this thing, then you'll be able to write. So that's how it is for me. So it's two different parts of my brain, because the cover is important. The cover is extremely important. So because today we live in a, you know, in a visual world on the internet, like, you know, all over the world, people are looking at it. Not so in the, you know, maybe 20 years back when the internet was not there, when e-books were not there, it was okay because people read it because people had a lot of time. Today, the cover has to grab you. You'll probably pick up a book only if the cover grabs you, you know. So these things are important, but I don't think about them at all when I'm writing. And when I finish writing, there are other people. Designer hai, publisher hai, it's their job. Mera kaam hai likhna. Main yehi prayatna karungi ki achcha se achcha, just as much as I can, I will tell the story in the best way that I can. The rest of it is, you know, in the reader's hand and in the publisher's hand. Because at some point, you have to leave that control. And I leave it after I finish my edits.
So, coming back to the writer.
Right.
And this is a question in continuation to my previous question.
Right.
Aisi koi khas jagah, ya ghar mein, ya bahar, when you go. Matlab, in the house, do you have a specific place? Ki kamra band karke main yahan baith ke likhti hun, I get the best ideas, or I can actually write further, write better. Or are you a person like, if you're in the flight, you pick out, you know, your paper and pen and you start writing?
Right.
And also, that when you are writing and you leave your book, or you're writing at a certain sentence or a paragraph,
right,
or a page,
right,
how do you manage to get back to it? You know,
right,
you come out to the world,
right,
and you're going back.
Right.
There's something really, it's, I want to really know,
right,
this. It's,
right,
an,
right,
art. I want,
right,
to learn too.
Right.
How do you do it?
No, it's very difficult. It's very difficult to balance real life and your book life. So, you know, one trick which I do, which you guys might find very funny. So when I'm writing a book, when I'm going out for a walk, I don't wear my glasses. So I can't see who those people are, okay? Because I'm so lost in my thinking. So I go out for a walk with my dog. So I can't see them. So if they see me and, you know, so I don't talk to anybody, because if I do it, that flow goes. So, you know, people probably think I'm rude, because that's fine by me. But this is the reason, you know, because I'm so into the story that I can't really go socialize. I won't go for parties. I won't visit anybody when I'm writing. And yeah, I do have a specific place in my room, on my bed. And I have a dog. So my dog is always next to me. And I keep my hand on my dog and then I write. But ideas can come to me anywhere. So jo 100 little flames hai, uski shuruaat ek post-it note pe hui thi. So maine recently Instagram pe ek, dala tha ki wo post-it note. एक आइडिया ऐसे आई थी जो जब भी आइडियाज आते हैं मैं इमीडिएटली लिखती हूँ वो आइडियाज एंड देन आई स्टक दैट पोस्ट नोट लेटर दैट डेवलप्ड इनटू अ नॉवल सो आइडियाज कैन अकर एनी टाइम सो व्हेन आई एम राइटिंग अ नॉवल इट्स अ वेरी कॉन्शियस डिसीजन टू शट आउट फ्रॉम द आउटसाइड वर्ल्ड बिकॉज आई डोंट वॉन्ट दैट इंटरफियरेंस इनसाइड माई हेड सो आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू थिंक अबाउट यू नो दाल जल गया यू नो आज क्या बनाना है डिनर पे लाइक आई मीन आई कांट थिंक अबाउट इट दैट वे And I do use the apps. And now, you know, the lady who helps me, my helper, she also knows. So she tells me in Kannada, Madam, aap Alexa li haki, because she knows I'll forget. So she's telling me, tell Alexa to remind you. And my reminder in Alexa is, please switch off the gas. Okay, because I'll forget. I'll switch it on and I'll forget. I'll be writing. And after burning that, you know, boiled eggs I have burnt. So after doing that, now she tells me, Madam, Alexa li haki. So I'll say, okay, fine, Alexa, remind me to switch off gas. Now Alexa reminds me. So because I'm totally lost, it's very, very difficult for a person who is writing to navigate the real world, honestly. But when I finish writing, then I'm okay, you know, then I won't forget to switch off the gas, then I'm okay meeting people, then I'm okay traveling, then I'm okay, you know, meeting my readers. But when I'm writing, I'm isolated.
Very nice. My next question to you is that aapki ek recent kitab jo aapne samne aa rahi hai, Sab Sitaro Ka Khel Hai.
Right.
Which is the most intriguing and the touching part which you would like to share with the audience here?
In this one?
Yeah.
अगर मैं बताऊं तो वो सस्पेंस चला जाएगा ना.
थोड़ा सा तो हिंट तो दे दो.
तो ये कहानी जो है बेंगलुरु में सेट है. And this has been translated, incidentally. It's in English, it's all in the planets. Aur Aniket ki kahani hai. There's a boy called Aniket and he's working in Bangalore. And agar Bangalore mein hoga to kya kaam karega? IT mein kaam karega. So he's a character who's working in IT and he's overweight. Okay, he's fat. He's let himself go. And he's got this stunning girlfriend. So it's a very fun book. Okay, he's got this stunning girlfriend who is a model. So he can't believe that he's got this girlfriend. And she has a long list of things for him to change. Wo bolti hai, ye karo, ye karo, ye karo, you know, otherwise I'm out of here. So he's desperately trying to hold on to it. And it's very realistic. It's very, very realistic. And then he meets another girl on the train. You know, and the book starts in the train. They meet on a train. So it's a chance encounter. And what is interesting in this book, it starts with the zodiac sign. So this guy is a fire sign and she is she's also a fire sign. And then they start talking. So it starts with a prediction. Aur is kahani ke idea mujhe kaise aayi thi, main Delhi se Chandigarh ja rahi thi ek literature festival mein, to Shatabdi mein baithi thi. Tabhi maine ye paper, you know, I started reading the newspaper and I saw this zodiac sign. So then I started thinking, everybody reads the zodiac sign. How much of this is true? Kya, you know, jo bhi ye zodiac sign likhta hai, aise hi baith ke likhta hai, jaise main kahaniyan likhti hu, ya isme kuch hai, you know, is there some truth in it? So that's how the idea came to me. So I said, what if I write a book where I explore this? So I take a prediction and I give this prediction and end of the chapter, you come to know whether the prediction is right or not. So that's how I have written this book. So each chapter in this, you know, starts with a prediction. So I'm not sure how it reads out in Hindi. Yeah, it's the same. So you will see this little prediction here. And then you can see whether it comes true or not. And it's told from two points of view. Pehle jo hai Aniket ka point of view. Second chapter, Nidhi. Third chapter, Aniket. Fourth chapter, Nidhi. So it switches. So it's an extremely interesting, fun book. So that's what it is about this book.
तो इसी किताब के ऊपर एक छोटा सा सवाल और है.
Right.
अगर कोई कोड है तो शनाय ने उसे क्रैक किया है. तो
हिंदू ने बोला था ना, हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर.
हाँ. तो ये क्या, कौन सा ऐसा कोड है जो क्रैक हुआ है?
वो हिंदू बारे में वो आपको हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर से ही पूछना पड़ेगा क्योंकि उन्होंने लिखा है. बिकॉज यू नो आई थिंक वॉट दे सेड इज इफ देयर इज अ कोड शनाय हैज क्रैक्ड इट. That too coming from the Hindu, because Hindu is so respected.
Yes. तो उसको एक suspense रखते हैं अभी थोड़ा time के लिए. अगला जो मेरा सवाल है, Preeti, do you feel like God sometimes?
I feel like dog, not God. No, I don't feel like God at all.
My question is that, you know, you are creating these characters.
Right.
You are weaving a story.
Right.
And you're kind of controlling these characters by the way you're writing. Mm-hmm. Right from their emotions to their lives to, you know, the way the entire story is going forward. So somewhere do you feel like it's only creativity or these are out of your imagination? Or sometimes you also take inspiration from real life people around you?
See, first of all, it's a myth that I control the characters. Okay, characters don't, I don't control the characters. They control me.
Okay.
The first time that it happened, मुझे लगा मैं पागल हो रही हूँ. ओके, सो बिकॉज इफ आई टेल पीपल दैट आई एम राइटिंग अ स्टोरी बट माई कैरेक्टर्स आर नॉट लिसनिंग टू मी, दे डोंट अंडरस्टैंड. दे आर लाइक, हाउ कैन इट बी, यू आर राइटिंग द स्टोरी, देन हाउ कैन योर कैरेक्टर्स नॉट लिसन टू यू. देन आई स्पोक टू माई राइटर फ्रेंड्स एंड दे सेड इट्स द सेम फॉर देम. देन आई सेड, ओह थैंक गॉड, यू नो आई एम नॉट मैड, आई फील नॉर्मल. सो इट्स अ मिथ बिकॉज यू गेट सो मच इनटू द स्टोरी, यू क्रिएट द कैरेक्टर एंड बिलीव मी, लाइक यू नो पीपल हु राइट will vouch that it's true. Characters take a life of their own. They don't listen to you. They do what they like because you give them certain traits and you create it and you write. And it's almost like I'm in a trance and I'm writing. I don't know, like, you know, though I have a plot in my head, sometimes the characters don't listen. So people ask me in 100 Little Flames, why did you do this? I said, I didn't do it. That's how the story came to me. So honestly, I don't. And then it's like I cannot think of anything else. The characters, I'm always hearing their voices in my head. I don't sleep, okay, because I get up early in the morning, I start writing till that story comes out. It's very difficult for me till the story comes out. I have to write it. So I become obsessed with the story, and that I think shows in my writing. So I don't control the characters. The characters control me. And do I take inspiration from real life people? Definitely. Because I feel my characters have to be relatable. So, you know, you never know. Next character might be like Vishal, you know. Might be set in a hotel. You never know.
Okay. So I'll take credits for that.
Yeah, you can.
You know, the only woman and, you know, highest selling league. But I was just wondering that what if Preeti Shenoy was a male writer? Mm-hmm. Would you be writing any differently?
I don't know about that. I think a lot more young teenage girls will be in love with me if I was a male writer because that's what we see in India. But see, I write from both points of view. Okay, I write from the male point of view and from the female point of view. For example, this book, Aniket. So when people read the male point of view, young men write to me and they say, how did you know this? Okay, how can you write? So I essentially feel writers, it's a human experience that you're capturing. So if you take out whether the writer is a male or a female, what is important is the connect, how you capture the story, how you tell the story. The name doesn't matter, at least not in India. Even J.K. Rowling, she didn't give the name as, you know, she didn't give her real name. She gave J.K. Rowling because she wanted people to think it was a guy. So like, fortunately in India, I think we don't have that, you know, whether it's a woman writing or a guy writing. If it's a good story, people will still buy the book. So, yeah, I do write from both points of view.
Preeti, being constantly nominated in the Forbes list, mm-hmm. and being so popular, you've done India proud. There are a lot of women who are inspired by you. They actually connect with you. And I'm sure there are a lot of women who are also in love with you as a writer. And they follow your blogs. And I've seen the kind of posts you showed me. And I read, which they constantly write. You're an inspiration for millions. Who's your inspiration?
See, for me, I take my inspiration from daily life. Anything that happens to me daily. See, mainly I'm grateful. Okay, honestly, I'm very grateful to be here. I'm grateful to each and every one of you who has come and who is listening to me, who is reading what I'm writing. So I feel very inspired by that. One big source of inspiration is my father. I lost my father all of a sudden in 2006. One moment he was sitting in the chair speaking to my mother. The next moment he had shut his eyes and he was gone. Death was that sudden. I was devastated. I was in Pune at that time. I couldn't bear it. It was like so unfair because my father was so fit. And he was, even that morning he has walked 5 kilometers. He had no age-related ailment, nothing. He was so fit and he was so young, okay? And he used to never wear a hair dye or anything. His hair was jet black. He had, people wouldn't, you know, looking at him, you won't say like he's 64 he was when he passed away. So that was no age. And 1 week later, he was to come to Pune where I was based. So for me, it was like someone had pulled the rug under my feet. I said, death can be that sudden. Then what is life? You know, if that is death, what is life? And I was so hurt. I was so sad. And then I said, okay, you know, we don't have control over what happens to us. But we have control over what we focus on. Okay, so I said, I'm going to focus. And I was in a dark place. And how much can I cry? I had 2 little children at that time. So I didn't want to be crying when my children came home. So I said, I'm going to start a blog where I will focus only on the positive things. Okay, we can be grateful for small things. Someone made a cup of tea for you. Oh, I'm grateful. Someone has made this. I'm in this position today where someone, you know, it's small things like that. I saw a rainbow in the sky. I was happy. I said, little by little, I crawled back because grief was devastating. So that's how I started blogging. And to this day, you will not find a single ad on my blog. Okay, because I said that blog is what connected me to people. And you can see my posts. Even now, I do a blog marathon, which means I blog every day. Nobody pays me for it. And you guys can go blog.preetishenoy.com and you can subscribe and you'll get a post in your inbox.
So only positivity, only that I focus on. And that's how this journey, you know, came to be.
So I pray for your dad, and I think somewhere it's a tribute back to him, and you are, you know, he's watching over you.
Absolutely, I always believe that.
So going on to the next question is that you've written, I think that's the 11th book.
Right.
If I'm correct.
Yes.
Which is the book which you feel as a, you know, genre which everybody can, a man, woman, a teenager, an adult, which any person can relate to or read? Would you like to recommend any book of yours?
So I'll share one incident that happened, and this was the book where I met my oldest reader and my youngest reader. Okay, the book was Secret Wishlist, and people love that book. Even young people love that book, and I was surprised because I said, how can someone, you know, this girl had come, this was in Gurgaon, and a 14-year-old girl had come, and she said, I love this book. And then I said, you read this book, because the book has extramarital affair in it. It has marital rape in it. So I said, you read this book? I was shocked. And I said, your mom lets you read this book? And the mother was with her. You know, she said, nowadays kids know everything. I want her to read it so that she's aware. So she took a photograph with me, and that was my youngest reader. Okay, she was 14. Then the same book, when I went to Chennai, one 84-year-old lady, she came and hugged me. And she said, Preeti, I really feel you have written my story, except the extramarital part, extramarital affair part, she said. And she said, you know, so I felt so happy. So I said, I want to take a photo with you. She's saying, you want a photo with me? I said, yeah, because, you know, no one this old has read my book. So that one book, from 14 to 84, I was quite stunned, because the book does have teenage love in it. Then what happens is one incident changes her life, then it has marriage in it. So I'm guessing that that book, you know, anyone can relate. And okay, and the same book, what happened is there was a man who wrote to me, and he said, after reading that book, he said it was such an eye-opener, and he said, I read only non-fiction and business books. But he was traveling from Bombay to Dubai, and he was bored in the airport. He saw this book and he picked it up, and he says, when I finished reading, he says, I'm a guy who never cries or never gets moved. He says, there were tears in my eyes, because he says, I have never asked my wife what she wants. Okay, so he went and he asked his wife, what is your wish list? And he, in his mind, wife was very happy, because they had a traditional marriage, they had an arranged marriage, and, you know, two kids. And then his wife said, his wife was stunned, okay, and his wife said, I want to wear a gown, a red gown like Julia Roberts. And then he's saying, I didn't even know who Julia Roberts was. Like in Pretty Woman, she was wearing this red gown. And then he sent me his family photo. He sent me long mails. He says, I can't thank you how this book has changed my life, changed our marriage. Then one young man, he read this book, and he said, I went and asked my mother what her wish list is, and I'm going to make each of her wishes come true. So that book, you know, I never expected it to, you know, touch so many people from varied age groups. So probably, yeah, that would be the book. So
I don't know about this man, but I surely will do this in the evening.
Yeah, actually, it's so important, yeah, when husbands ask the wife, okay, what do you want? What are your wishes?
Absolutely.
Small
so
thing.
Important.
It's so important, yeah, and the wives feel so good, because I do feel as women, I feel Indian women are conditioned, okay, to be mothers and wives. Okay, a simple thing I'll tell you, we go to a hotel, okay, the husband or the father will order what he wants, the kids will order what he wants. Always observe, the wife or the mother will say, okay, it's okay, I'll take this. Why? Because each one is getting what they want. In being in the hotel industry, you must be knowing this.
Sure.
So, you know, and then she will make do with, okay, so whatever the kid orders, whatever this orders. And I know this because even I am guilty of the same. So when I went, after my kids were grown up, the first time in my life, okay, after about 18 or 19 or 20 years of marriage, I went with a woman friend of mine to Goa. And the biggest pleasure for us was going to a hotel and ordering what we want. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that? Because, and every person here would be able to relate to it. Because we sacrifice so much here. Who asks? Who comes and asks us, what are your wishes? Nobody is asking. Anyone who's been married 10 years knows this. Your husband, like, you know what?
I can completely relate to it. In fact, last evening, I was walking around, and our chef and our F&B team, So we usually talk to our guests and take feedback.
Right.
And there was a big family who has come from Jaipur, and they were having dining, you know, in the coffee shop here at Neelmel. And I happened to ask the family, I said, so are you enjoying the dinner? They were parents and a big family of 8-10 people. So the kids and everybody said, ah, bother chai, it's very nice, very good. So before I left, I said, but it has to be certified by the lady.
Yeah, yeah.
And they all started laughing, and which is a fact that we need to give that importance to
absolutely,
the women too.
Yeah.
Moving forward, there is a sense or a connect which every writer has, no matter what the storyline be. And somewhere where we see that connect is that your books, they talk about a short message that life is short and live it to the fullest.
Absolutely, yes.
Pura life ko pura jiyo.
Absolutely.
So, do you agree with that? And what's
100%. 100%. You have to, because see, today I'm sitting in front of you. Yeah. 2 hours later, you don't know what will happen. My father's death taught me that. A person can be hale and hearty. You don't know what is coming. You don't know from where it's coming. So this moment, if you're here, be grateful. If someone is there in your life who is genuine to you, be grateful. Nurture those relationships. You have parents alive, please call them every single day. You know, don't become so busy that you don't call your parents and you don't talk to your parents. I call my mom every day. Every day after my father passed away, not a single day has gone by when I don't call her. Because, you know, it's so important. Yeah, these are small things. These are small things which make life more meaningful. So important to live it to the fullest. Do things that make you feel happy. Every day, do one thing that makes you feel happy, you know. So when you go to bed, okay, you know, I feel happy today because I've done this. I feel these things are so important, and that's the message I try and give through my blog posts, through my books, but it, you know, woven in interesting stories.
So I'll kind of wind off this conversation. I'm sure people are very impatient, the audience, to ask you questions too.
Sure.
But two very quick ones.
Right.
Being an avid writer, blogger, an artist, illustrator, and you told me you got two grown-up children.
Yes.
Teenage children.
Yeah.
It's almost, I'm sitting next to
adult,
a
adult children.
You know? So how do you do all this? How do you manage all this? What's the secret?
I think when you say, when you juggle things, okay, it implies you're not happy doing it because you're anxious or tense. But for me, I don't have a boss. So I am my own boss. Okay, so I answer totally myself. So I don't have anyone sitting there. I don't have to go to office, and so I do what I like. And for me, my first priority is my family. That I was very clear. So for me, one simple thing which I followed was, when my children come home from school, the reason I gave up a corporate job was I wanted to be there for my children, you know. Because when my son was born, for me, he was the most precious thing I have ever been given. So I said, I can't imagine giving him off to daycare, or, you know, I was a very hands-on mother, or a very possessive mother, whatever you want to call it. So I said, when my children come from school, I will stop writing. So when they come at 3:30, so my writing time was when they go to school at 7:30 till 3:30. That's my time. I will write in that time when they come. Not because anyone told me to, but because I said they are small only now. Yeah, I want to be there for them. I want to hear about their day. I want to cook for them. That's a choice I made. Now they are grown up. Now they don't live with me anymore. My son is 21. My daughter is 18. Both live abroad. So now my time is entirely my own, except for my little doggy, you know, which is my, not little doggy, big doggy. And I have a little hamster who's a rescue. So other than that, my time is entirely my own.
So my closing question.
Right.
It's been a pleasure to talk to you and honor to have you with us here. And you are a legend in yourself, and the legacy which you have, the writing which you do. Would you like to give a tip to the young writers, and would you like to tell your fans something, a message which you would like to give across to society?
I would just say, make time to read. Okay, read every single day. If you're an aspiring writer, read a lot of books. And if you want tips on how to read, because when I tell people to read, they say we don't have time for reading. So I've written an article, okay, 5 easy ways to read more and change your life. It's there on my Instagram, it's there on my blog post, there on my website. Read a lot and write every single day if you're an aspiring writer. That riyaz, what I talked about, the practice, very important. You know, write every single day. And to all of us here, just, I feel gratitude changes life. If you're grateful for what you've been given, you'll be given more of that. Extremely important to be grateful. And just be positive and happy. Our life is so short, there's no point keeping, you know, oh, this one did this to me, that one did that to me. No point thinking about it. Just leave it aside and move on. That's my message.
Thank you so much. It has been a pleasure. And this moment of my life, I'll remember. With that, I would like to open the floor to the audience here to ask you questions. And I leave you at the center of the stage.
Thank you so much, Vishal. Thank you.
Pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot.
I think they're spellbound.
I thought I would be asking. He has already stolen them.
Okay.
But still, what I would like to ask you now is, who, if you could tell us who your favorite authors are and what are the top five books that you think are the good ones apart from yours.
Right, of course.
Your favorite five books authors.
Yeah, like, you know, I have, on my Instagram, in fact, if you go to the highlights, I have, this year my goal is to read 100 books.
I am not in Instagram, so if you could...
I'll tell you. So, this year, last year I read 35 books. This year my goal is 100 books. And today is, what's the date? 11th. I've already finished 4 books. I read a lot, okay? So, if you ask me favorite authors, I'll talk for 2 hours. So, I don't...
Name 5.
Yeah, I will
name
tell
five.
You. One is Michael Morpurgo, Audrey Niffenegger, Roald Dahl's Writing for Adults, Christine Hannah I like. So many authors I like. I like, in Indian, I like Ruskin Bond. I like Manu Joseph. I like Shiny Antony. I read a lot. And I feel all of these write so wonderfully. I love their work. Leanne Moriarty I read. And right now I'm reading this author called Sally Rooney. So, and whatever I read, I share. Because I feel if it's a nice book, I want more people to read it, you know. So, it's not that, read only my book. That'll be a very narrow-minded view. So there are such wonderful books out there. So read more. Read a lot. You know, very important, I feel, to read. And one book which I would tell everyone to read is Tuesdays with Maury. Fantastic book. Mitch Albom, again, one of my favorite writers. It's a beautiful, beautiful book. So that book, I would say, read. Everyone should read that book.
Thank you.
Thanks.
So when you read so much... don't your books get influenced by it?
No, not at all. Because if you read my books, my voice is my voice. Because just because you read, it's like saying, if I look at many paintings, will I paint like them? You know, I won't. Because ultimately, it's coming from inside me and it's my unique experiences and my style and my writing. And touch wood, yeah, I have found that voice. Because my voice is strong and unique. You know, if you read my books, you'll know that. So it's not like any of the authors that I have read.
This book that you have over here, that's in Hindi, isn't it?
Right. This one is, it's translated to Hindi.
It's translated to Hindi. So, as a native speaker, like you said, Konkani is your mother tongue.
Right.
And English is your primary language.
Right.
Do you think change of the language's translation can capture the essence of the writer? Because I know language makes a huge difference, the way you try to express it in English, the way it is translated in Hindi or any other language. Do you think these kind of books capture the essence that you are trying to portray in the original language?
Yes, I believe so. Because, four or five of my books have been translated to Malayalam. And my mom reads Malayalam. She's very fluent in Malayalam because she's born and brought up in Kerala. So I asked her this question. So I couldn't read it. But she read it. She said it's beautifully translated. It's translated very well. And essentially, it's Indian writing. So if I was trying to capture, if my books were set in, Victorian London, or if it was set in UK, then probably something might be lost in translation. Incidentally, I also read a lot of translated works. So I have read Benjamin's Goat Days. It's originally written in Malayalam. It's translated into English. I have read Vaikyam Muhammad Bashir, who writes in Malayalam, translated to English. That translation was not done too well. But the story was fantastic. So I think we don't give enough credit to our translators because some of them do such fabulous jobs. And I think it's very, very nice that books are written because I can read, I can read in languages which I can't read if they were not translated. So I think it depends on the translator really.
Thank you.
I believe you will because that's why I said, no, it's a strong voice. So I would really actually like to test this. You know, I'll probably put one passage from me and one passage from some other author and one passage. It's a very interesting experiment, and I'll say identify which is mine. I'm pretty sure people will identify. Because see, some of the usages that I have, my editor is constantly making notes. Okay, I have not heard this usage. Because see, I don't know where it's coming from. It's not that I'm doing it deliberately to be different. But yeah, I believe you will be able to identify. I'll be happy, in fact, if people identify.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Yeah. There couldn't have been a better setting. A house full of wonderful people and a torchbearer. After listening to Preeti Shenoy, I'd like to quote Atticus. She wasn't looking for a knight. She was looking for a sword. Ma'am, subjects of your stories cut through the layers of conventional relationships and scrape feminism with finesse. We learned that atrocities do not have shape and form. We are grateful and proud to have you as our guest author, and by your words, you've made strong look invincible and broken look beautiful. Thank you from all of us here, from Ehsaas Women and from Prabha Khaitan Foundation. Thank you, friends, for being here with us. Your support is admirable. I extend my gratitude towards the media representatives for spreading the word of culture and literature across the region. I'd like to request Shubh Singhvi of Ehsaas to come forward and present a token of appreciation.